Hello and welcome back to the finals of the World Championship in Through the Ages. In my last game I had a solid result with finishing second in a 4-player game, and with that I'm still in the lead with 5 games finished and 18 points. And the next game that we are seeing today is another 4-player game, and now without further ado, we are going to take a look at the game. In this game I'm in the second position, and first of all we can take a look at the Leaders and Wonders. And we can see that there is some theater synergy in H3 with Chaplin and Marlene Dietrich, as well as the Hollywood and the Internet being there. But there are also some lab leaders with Sid Meier, Bill Gates and Einstein. However, again, no spaceflight, but at least Internet and Manhattan Project are there. Also Gandhi is there, and as well as the Manhattan Project for the military. Mandela is in the game, the Red Cross is in the game as well. In H2 we have some interesting wonders. There is the Suez Canal, James Cook, so a colonization game could definitely be interesting. There's also the Ocean Liner Service and Maria Theresa. There are some culture leaders in H2 with Shakespeare, Gaudi, Darwin and Bach, so actually quite a bunch of them, and one military action leader with Catherine. In H1 we have Machu Picchu, Universitas, some strong economic leaders, St. Peter's Basilica, Amici Castle. We have two military action leaders in H1 with Jan Šiška and Chernov Ark, Barbarossa, Nostradamus can both help with the strength, Isabella, Columbus, Eleanor and Barbarossa maybe can work nicely in a colonization game with the Suez Canal, so that could maybe be interesting. So definitely some interesting stuff in the game. And Swin is in first position, he has only one leader or wonder available for him, and at the end he also makes the decision to go for him with going for Alex. And then it's my turn and I end up going for the Rome Roads here. I think that should be a solid decision. I don't want to take just 2 yellow cards, and it's just the only wonder available on the row. It's definitely a decent wonder, there are some leaders coming down the row. It might be though that Ashoka and Hippocrates will be taken away. Then it would only be Caesar and Sansu left, and without having a synergizing wonder, it would maybe not be too great to go for them, but at least I'm in second position, so maybe I could still try to go for a little bit of an aggressive play. So I think that could still be fine, or I can hope for another leader to come out, but there are only Aristotle and Boudicca in the deck, and I might have to pay 2 or even more civil actions for them, or I might have to delay electing them. So I at least considered maybe just taking Ashoka, and then at the next turn I can maybe elect him, build a mine, increase my population, take yellow card, and then I could hope that at the turn after that there is just one of those wonders available. Maybe I could even get lucky and get an early Universitas or something like this, so I think that could also be a fine start. But the Colosseum is fine, and for player games Colossus with the colonization synergy could be fine. Acropolis, maybe not too strong in 4-player games, the Pyramids, so it could also be an interesting idea, but at the end I went for the Rome Roads. Then Himmelstosh will go for the Richland and Ashoka. I think that makes a lot of sense going for Ashoka plus a yellow card here. Mata Beshear will then go for Frugality, and interestingly he goes for Sansu, even though he's in last position, but he has maybe the chance to set up a nice colonization game. There's Šiška, there's Columbus, there's also Barbarossa, so definitely some synergy, and with that he is willing to go for Sansu, even though there could have been maybe also Hippocrates. So an interesting decision by him. Then H1 starts and Swin goes for Alex. There's not really any wonder available for cheap for him, so he just builds a mine, increases his population and takes the frugality. I was hoping that maybe he would take the engineering genius, but I think for himself it might be better to take this. But I also won't take it, meaning that it will be available for one civil action now for one of my opponents. And with Mata Beshear going for Sansu, Hippocrates is available for me, and I will just go for him. I think he should be a fine leader. I didn't want to go for Caesar, because one of my opponents might still go for the Colossus. And so I just go for Hippocrates, build a mine, increase my population and do some normal stuff. I draw the Raider so I can potentially seed and a colonization card. Himmelstosh goes for Ashoka, builds the mine, uses the rich land, but he will take a new yellow card this turn with the engineering genius. So he doesn't commit to a wonder yet, but there is actually the Universitas coming down the row. However, Mata Beshear and Swin also both don't have a wonder, so the chances for him to get Universitas are maybe not that big, but maybe he could still have a shot at, for example, getting the Colossus. He then draws 2 cards. Mata Beshear is actually willing to pay 3 civil actions for the Universitas, and an early Universitas is definitely quite strong. He still gets the mine going, will delay electing Sansu for now, but he has this early Universitas and that is definitely quite strong. Pyramids 1 maybe could have been also fine, but I think it definitely might be worth it to go for this Universitas, especially as it also means that the opponents won't have access to that. now it's Swin's turn. He will increase his population, takes the pyramids, so he also gets a strong wonder, and then he will just take the first copy of knights. There is still, even though he isn't elected yet, Sansu in the game, and in general having the knights in 3 and 4 player games is just very nice. And Swin can at the next turn then maybe even just finish the pyramids. He delayed his lab for now. I will take the alchemy this turn, and I could potentially build a second lab now, then I would even have enough resources to go for, or enough science to go for the alchemy already the next turn, but instead I made it differently, built 2 stages of the Rome Roads, and then I took the Urban Growth. Like this, I think I can use my civil actions relatively nicely. I mean, taking the Urban Growth is maybe not ideal, but with me like this not getting into consumption, and the alternative would maybe be to increase my population, but then, but now that I don't do it, the Urban Growth basically gives me a resource and a food for only 1 civil action, which I think is a fine deal. I delay my science production, and I might also not be able to build up some science production at the next turn, but in 2 turns I can then just build an alchemy directly, make a very efficient move, and hopefully then with going for the alchemy I can make up for delaying the science production for a little bit. And thanks to the urban growth, even if there are no developments revealed, I can now in 2 turns, in the next turn I can finish the Rome Roads. Then I have 1 resource left, plus 4 production, and in 2 turns, thanks to the urban growth, I can build an alchemy directly even without any help from the developments. I draw 2 cards, the Crusades and the Dark Ages. Himmelstosh builds the second lab, takes Isabella interestingly, and the Colossus, and with Isabella activates the plus 1 resource production bonus from Ashoka, and I think he definitely has a plan here. Takes the Colossus, takes Isabella, there is a lot of colonization synergy, and so maybe he can set up a nice colonization game and go for the Suez Canal later on. Mata Bashir will go for Sansu, goes for an early monarchy, and then doesn't build his second lab. Instead, he just saves up some resources to finish the Universitas relatively soon. And then Swin will finish the pyramids this turn, reveals the phalanx tactics, so he maybe had this already in hand a turn before when he took the knights, and then he also takes 2 yellow cards, and just now has like this, some more resources available for him. Now it's my turn, there have been no developments revealed yet, so I will finish the Rome Roads this turn. At the next turn I can then build an alchemy directly, so that will be fine. And now I still have 2 civil actions left. I could consider going for the St. Peter's Basilica, it might be a fine wonder to have, could help me with a happy face illusion, could also synergize nicely with those H2 culture leaders, so I think it's definitely something to consider. And I think it could be fine, but at the end I still made a decision against going for the St. Peter's Basilica. The other H1 wonders are maybe also not that great to get for me. I mean, Maitri Castle, of course, can be fine, but for Machu Picchu, I would still need the iron and also maybe ideally the irrigation. So, no. I mean, without having another H1 wonder, it could be easier to maybe be set up for some H2 wonders like the Ocean Liner service. So, I think it could be a fine play to go for the St. Peter's Basilica here, but it's also not that strong that I think it is a must play, and instead I went for something different. I could also just take the iron, but I think that would not be that good of a move, because I have already something to upgrade my economy with going for the alchemy, and then I think it's just too big of a price to pay. I can still hope to get another copy of iron maybe later on for cheaper. For now I can just upgrade the alchemies anyway, so I think there's no need to grab the iron for 2 civil actions. And so instead I first of all increase my population. What I considered was taking Eleanor here, because I have Hippocrates, getting an early replacement could be quite nice, but I also think I'm maybe not that ideally set up for Eleanor. Himmelstosh has the Colossus, Mata Bashir has Sansu, Swin has the first copy of Knights, so all of them are at the moment I think better prepared for an early switch of the event deck, so I didn't really want to go for Eleanor at the end, and rather wanted to wait for another leader. Leader maybe that can also help me potentially with the military, and so instead I then took the Richland with my last civil action so that I can maybe start setting up the alchemy, and then even though I stay on bronze mines for a while, can then maybe quickly upgrade also some iron or coal mines later on. I draw 2 cards, another colonization cards, which is nice, and also the new deposits. Himmelstosh will go for the alchemy, goes for 1 upgrade, and to get out of corruption he has to increase his population, at least still has the resource bonus going from Ashoka. Denmark Top Assure will offer the Naval Trade Agreement, he will get 2 additional blue tokens, Himistosh will get an additional colonization force, and with him having Isabella, the Colossus, he definitely might be inclined to go for some colonies at some point, but it will also take a while until the event deck is flipped, so for now, the 2 additional blue tokens might just be very nice for Top Assure to have. He will increase his population now with the frugality, builds 1 stage of the Universitas, takes the iron and the rich land, makes use out of the pact immediately, and so at the next turn he can finish the Universitas, and thanks to the rich lands, he can then maybe also get some iron production going very quickly. He also reveals the Legion tactic, so there's maybe a chance that this tactic will get upgraded at some point. Swin then also, same as me, will need a new leader. That was also why I considered going for Eleanor, because if there is now a leader like Joan of Arc, it's likely that Swin might take this leader away, and now he will go for Joan of Arc, gets the third military action, builds an additional lab to get some science production going, takes the Code of Laws, so the next turn could potentially develop the Code of Laws. And now it is my turn, and this turn I will just get the alchemy going. I have just enough science to develop it, and there actually have been still no developments revealed, so now it is very nice to have the urban growth, as it allows me to build the second alchemy. And then I think it's very important to take those knights here. There's still Sansu in the game, there's still some leaders that maybe could allow my opponents to potentially get strong, and I will actually also copy the phalanx tactic this turn, and I think that could potentially be an important move, because Swin has this tactic already lying around. He has the knights in hand, he has the patriotism, he has enough population that the next turn he could go for a phalanx tactic, and then he could already be quite threatening. Sadly, I don't have enough science to go for the knights already at the next turn, but there's maybe at least a chance that I could develop them with some developments. But even without going for the knights at the next turn, I might maybe want to already build some warriors. For example, if Swin goes for another army, he will be at 7 strength. Then I could potentially build 2 warriors at the next turn, and with the 2 defense cards I would just be able to defend myself, and in 2 turns I could then build a knight, and without copying the tactic now, I would then, I would not be able to have the tactic then in 2 turns. I could of course hope to maybe draw a tactic, but that's also definitely not a given, so I think just investing my 2 military actions now to copy the tactic could end up being quite an important move. But sadly, I don't have enough science to go for the knights at the next turn, and also not enough resource to go for this army, so I could potentially still get a little bit into trouble. Himmelstor's seeds in the development of crafts is revealed. He will go for 1 more alchemy upgrade, increase his population, takes the Code of Laws, builds 1 stage of the Colossus, has now finally the full Oshoko bonus going, has the Code of Laws, which is a nice thing to invest into with having 4 science production going, and also can maybe then finish the Colossus at the next turn, get Isabella going. So definitely not a bad position for him. Mata Peshur's seeds in the development of markets is revealed. He will take 2 additional food from that, can now increase his population 2 times, finishes the Universitas, and it's just this turn, but at the next turn it's very nice for him. He has 5 resources, so if he wants to and if he doesn't get distracted by anything, he could even just go for 3 iron upgrades thanks to his 2 rich lands at the next turn. Now it's Swin's turn. He will offer the Open Borders Agreement to Mata Peshur, and then he will go for the knight, so he will indeed start building some military. Builds also a warrior, and then sadly he will also build a religion, so he's not only going up to 7 but even to 8 strength, and that definitely makes things quite a bit dangerous for me. And then he also takes the breakthrough, which makes a lot of sense. And with him going up to 8 strength, there is basically nothing I can do against this. I can't set myself up to defend myself, I can only build 2 warriors, and that is not enough, then I would still not have enough to defend myself. I can go for Bread and Circuses and build 1 warrior. If I don't go for this upgrade, I have enough resources, but that's also not enough. I don't have enough civil actions to go for Bread and Circuses and build 2 warriors, so I can't make it that I can defend against the potential aggression anyway. So I think the best thing is just to ignore it, set myself up to maybe defend myself at the next turn, but for now just increase my economy. So I will go for 1 more alchemy upgrade. I will increase my population 2 times, so that I'm out of corruption, and with my last civil action, I then still took the iron. Alternatively, I could have gone for a happy face solution like Bread and Circuses. There's no Pierre in there, sadly, but at least Darwin, and there's only 1 copy of Theology left, so it could have been an idea, But I can maybe also go for phalanx tactic without having the Breton circuses and with having the rich land. I thought it could just be quite nice to be able to go for the iron relatively soon, but it definitely could be considered and has the potential to make me safer for the military if I have this Breton circuses ongoing. And at the next turn I thought that maybe Barbarossa could be an interesting option. Mata Pecheur, I thought, first of all, he doesn't have that many civil actions, so he can't take him cheaply, and maybe if he has a strong colony, Columbus could also be a very strong option, so I was hoping that maybe Barbarossa could be available, and then I could even build a warrior on the knight just with him, which was also the reason why I was not willing to build a warrior already this turn, because I thought it might be nice to build those units with Barbarossa, and also while I then, because of my only having two military actions, can only go for one warrior and a knight at the next turn, with having the two defense cards, I then hopefully should still be safe. There's of course the danger that I get disrupted, like with a blunder, and maybe my food could get blundered, but even with when getting hit by an aggression and by a blunder, I am still set up to defend myself. I mean, a kidnap that takes my knights away could of course be quite bad, but Swin has the knights already, so he should be more inclined to go for another aggression. I draw the rebellion and the developed territory. The development of agriculture is revealed, and Himmelstosh gain, now all players gain 2 additional food out of this. He increases population, finishes the Colossus, is now at 3 strength, so he will increase the strength by a bit, and goes up to, takes the Breton circuses, the breakthrough, and then goes up to 5 strength, and with me not being able to, for certain from Swin's perspective that I can it's certain for Swin that I can't defend against an aggression, so the other players just need to set themselves up that they potentially could defend, even if they don't have the defense card, and then it should be enough to be safe for now. Mata Pecheur seeds again, so another event is seeded. He will then do a revolution to monarchy and builds 2 warriors, so he will delay the iron upgrade for now, but has a cheap monarchy going, and goes for 2 more warriors, maybe is hoping to get Jan Šiška at some point. And sadly, as expected, there is an aggression from Swin. He didn't go for this strength push without a reason, and the raid is definitely quite hurtful for me. I have some alchemies going. Swin gets 3 additional resources, but in case if I want to rebuild this alchemy, it costs me 6 resources and a civil actions, and I miss out on the science production for now. So I think a raid in such a situation is definitely one of the hardest H1 aggressions to get hit by, and definitely not ideal that I lose this alchemy here. Swin takes the alchemy and, thanks to the additional resources, can even go for 2 upgrades, and then he increases his population to get out of corruption. The next turn he can potentially develop the Code of Laws if he wants to. And then at my turn I will go for Barbarossa. And because there's no Jan Šiška in the row, which of course also could be an interesting leader, also no Nostradamus, the development of agriculture has been revealed, so ideally if there are no rats or no anything that potentially cost me some food, I will be able to go for 2 Barbarossa activations this turn, and then even another at the next turn, and that's just a lot of value. It's already late in the age, so I think Barbarossa just can give me a lot of value here, and I was willing to even pay 2 civil actions for him. I will elect him, and then I will develop the knights, go for 1 for 2 activations, and with my last civil action I then took the urban growth, and with having rich land and urban growth I was hoping that I at least somewhat quickly can rebuild this alchemy while still getting a bit of iron production going. Then of course I keep the defense cards, and it is Himmelstosh's turn. He goes for the theocracy, and that of course also will help him defending, and then increases population and goes for some more units. It's not 9 strength, even the strongest, and also goes for the iron, so at the next turn he can potentially go for 2 iron upgrades. Mata Pecheur seeds, and the development of politics is revealed, so a lot of additional draws for every player. That also means that the deck got shuffled now. Mata Pecheur then goes for knights, builds 1 knight, goes for the iron, also 1 production, is now at 8 strength, and he will reveal the phalanx tactic, so not the legion, but the phalanx tactic will get upgraded, and he is probably hoping to get Jan Šiška, and with him has definitely quite a bit of potential. If he gets another knight going, he definitely could potentially be quite threatening, and with him hoping to go for Jan Šiška, of course he doesn't go for Nostradamus here, and at least it's not too bad for me that the phalanx tactic is upgraded, so I can copy the upgraded tactic at some point, maybe. Then Swin seeds and the development of civil life is revealed. And Swin will go for the code of laws with that. Takes the Himeji castle, interestingly, and the engineering genius. Maybe he had some issues with spending his civil actions in an efficient way, especially after he also got the development of civil life. And then he just takes Himeji castle, the engineering genius, maybe also sees this matter, that Mota Peugeot has some strength potential with potentially going for Jan Šiška. And then the Himeji castle is definitely not bad. Increases cultural production, protects him, and also in the late game it of course has some potential. And with the engineering genius, he will even be able to finish it at the next turn. Now H2 starts. And I will use Barbarossa one more time, spending all of my food. So if there are rats revealed, and now I have spent all of my food. And I'm also now at 9 strength, making it that I'm not the weakest. And after that, I develop the iron with the development of civil life. And now I will go for rebuilding this alchemy. I think I really want to get the science back again, the science production, so that I can maybe hopefully relatively soon go for an H2 government form. And then I have still enough resource to at least go for one iron upgrade. Sadly, I have not enough resource to go for 2 more at the next turn. That could have been quite nice. I could potentially take the reserves to enable this, but at the end I still rather went for the cultural heritage. It probably won't change how quickly I can go for an H2 government form, because at the next turn I have 7, then the cultural heritage is not enough to let me go for an H2 government form. In 2 turns I have 12 science anyway, but still, I think the science can just be very useful, but I think the reserves could also at least be considered. If I can play them, if there's nothing interesting in the row, I can potentially play them for resources and get 2 more mine upgrades going. Or if there's something like Good Harvest revealed, maybe I could even play them for food and get another Barbarossa activation going. But the cultural heritage is definitely also quite useful to have. I keep my defense cards and draw the Politics of Strength. Himmelstosh seeds and the vast territory is revealed, and as you can see, there are some very high bits. And my bit is maybe a little bit too high, but it's just such a strong colony to win with Barbarossa potentially. And but I thought with Himmelstosh having the strong colonization bonus, having had some draws, having Isabella, and with the Zeus Canal being in there, I thought he probably is willing to bid quite a lot for this colony. So I mainly wanted to push the price, but if I win it, I am in danger of an aggression, potentially even a double aggression, but at least my opponents didn't draw any H2 cards yet. So it would be dangerous, but it also has the potential to be quite nice. But as said, I, even with bidding 9, I still expected that Himmelstosh will bid more and even Swin bids more. And so at the end, Himmelstosh has at least to pay a little bit, but it's still relatively cheap. He only has to send 2 warriors and a resource, but at least he has to pay a little bit of a price, and also those defense cards are gone now for him. And Himmelstosh will now increase his population with the development of civil life, builds a warrior, and then goes for the cartography, so he maybe is expecting even more colonies to come, and with building another warrior he is even the strongest after he ends his turn. And now it is Mata Peugeot's turn. He will seed, and the barbarians are revealed. Swin has the most culture, he is also the weakest at the moment, so he will lose a population, which is definitely a bit annoying for him, as now he has only an unhappy population available. And Mata Peugeot this turn will of course go for Jan Šiška. The Spencer warrior can build a knight directly, is now at 14 strength, making him quite a bit threatening, and then he has also enough resource, thanks to the rich land, to go for one more mine upgrade. Has the theology in hand, but rather wants to have the organized religion. That's definitely the more efficient happy face solution. Could maybe have been also a nice thing for Swim to get with having Chin of Arc. And this turn, sadly, something unfortunate happens. The rebellion is revealed. And as you can see, actually a lot of civil actions are lost. Even Swin, who opened the rebellion, loses some civil actions. He knew this with Chin of Arc, but he also knows that both I and Mata Peugeot get hit quite a bit harder by this, especially because Swin has some civil actions anyway, and maybe he doesn't have the most important things to do anyway after doing those actions that he has done now. He could have had 2 left, he could have done some useful stuff, but it's nothing really important, so he just opens the rebellion now, and that is of course quite bad for me. I lose all of my civil actions, and also Mata Peugeot of course gets hit quite heavily by that, has now only 1 civil action. And maybe if you watched carefully, then you remember maybe that I actually not that long ago discarded the rebellion relatively at the end of H1, and so I was quite a bit unhappy that the rebellion wasn't this deck, because the deck got reshuffled when Marta Pêcheur pushed, then the development of politics got revealed, then it got shuffled, the deck, and then Swin must have drawn the rebellion because he pushed then, and then the deck got switched, so he probably drew the rebellion with the development of politics. So from my perspective, it was not really that likely that the rebellion is in there, but sadly it is in there. Swin got it and gets some nice benefits out of it now, so I definitely was unhappy about it, and that is of course quite a big setback, losing all of my civil actions and not being able to continue my upgrades. And then Swin will also copy the upgraded Phalanx tactic. Is it 11 strength now? Now it is my turn. I will build one more knight so that I'm at 11 strength. I want to be able to defend against an aggression. Also now I'm not the weakest, but apart from that, of course I can't do anything else because I lost all of my civil actions here. I will keep the defense cards and draw the emigration. Then Himmelstosh goes for the Rifleman. Goes for one upgrade, and even for another upgrade is now at 14 strength, makes sure to get stronger, and that's all that he will do. Marta Pêcheur seats, and the foray is revealed, so both Marta Pêcheur and Himmelstosh gain some additional resources and food. Marta Pêcheur will then increase his population, and he also can't do a lot more, he definitely also got hit quite heavily by the rebellion. Swin will seed, and sadly another event revealed that is not really great for me. I will lose now two civil actions to the call to arms, and so those last two turns definitely have not been great for me, with only being on four civil actions, losing four and now again losing two is quite a big setback, and the two draws definitely don't make up for that, and especially if Swin doesn't go for the Republic, I could have potentially even gone for the Republic at the next turn, when I wouldn't have gotten hit by this call to arms. Swin doesn't take the Republic, instead he takes this early coal, makes sure that he can go for some mine upgrades, and that he maybe can build up a nice economy, also takes the breakthrough, so after he goes for those coal upgrades, maybe he can then still, even though he has spent a lot of science in the coal, relatively quickly go for an H2 government form. Now it is my turn. I have two civil actions available this turn, and I will just use both of them to go for two mine upgrades. At least I have my production up going now. 6 resource production and 5 science production is definitely not bad, but I am still at 0 culture at the moment. Some of the opponents are also already producing some nice culture, and I'm still sitting at 4 civil and 2 military actions. At least at the next turn there might be the chance that I can then go for an H2 government form, because both Himmelstosh and Marta Pêcheur have an H1 government form, so it is not unlikely that either Republic or the Constitutional Monarchy will be available for me at the next turn. I could of course also maybe also only gone for one upgrade and taken one of those cards, but I think none of those cards is that great that it is worth it to miss out on the upgrade. And also this turn I will go for copying the upgraded Phalanx tactics. This of course means that I sadly miss out on some draws again, but at least it makes sure that I'm not the weakest, so I think that should be worth it, and maybe I want to copy it at some point anyway. Himmelstosh seats, and a wealthy territory is revealed, and as you can see, I again bid quite a bit for that, and this time I didn't want to win it at all, and maybe you should say I shouldn't bid then, but I mean, with the Suez Canal being in there, and Himmelstosh having invested that much to win those colonies, I just was 100% certain that he will bid a warrior and at least one resource with Isabella. I think that is almost for certain, and because of that I was willing to take the risk, maybe an unnecessary risk, but as you can see, none of the others bid very high, and because of me, Himmelstosh has actually to pay this resource, so he is has to pay one more resource now, so it's a bit of a risky move, but in a situation like this, where you can really say it almost for certain that Amistosh will go for this bid, I think it can also be worth it to just make sure that an opponent has to pay more, and it maybe also makes it look like that I have a lot of defense cards in hand, even though, I mean, I have only those H2, H1 cards, so that probably doesn't make a big difference. But Himmelstosh had to pay this one additional resource now, and who knows, maybe it will make a difference at some point. Himmelstosh then takes the Cavalryman, has now a Cavalry technology, and then goes for two Iron upgrades. And also goes for one more upgrade. Mata Pescheur seats, and the rats are revealed, but not a lot of food is lost, so those rats probably still remain quite hungry. And Mata Pescheur goes for cannons for three civil actions, disbands the warrior, builds a cannon, reveals the mobile artillery tactic, is even willing to disband another warrior, and then goes for another knight, and thanks to Jan Šiška and having those two farms, he has now the tactic three times, one time normally, two times outdated, and is now at 20 strength, so that is of course quite dangerous, and with that he might be setting up to maybe potentially go for an aggression at the next turn. And he also takes the Urban Growth. Swin, now that Mata Pescheur has gone for that much strength, will cancel the Open Borders Agreement. Maybe it makes a difference for him between being able to defend himself or not, or maybe he just doesn't want to give him all of the military actions now that he maybe plans on going for some aggressions or potentially some walls. And Swin wants to make sure that he is relatively safe, goes for the strategy, makes sure that he is not the weakest, and then also goes for one coal upgrade, so surprisingly he doesn't go for any H2 government form, but with Himmelstosh and Mata Pescheur being on H1 government forms, he knows that he will still get an H2 government form at some point. The next turn he doesn't have enough science anyway, he has already quite a lot of civil and military actions anyway, so he's maybe not in a hurry to get a government form, so I think that definitely makes sense in the strategy, makes him quite a bit safer with the additional strength, make sure that he is not the weakest. And he also didn't seed, so it could even mean that potentially there is a strength event on top. At least that means for me that the constitutional monarchy is still available. I think it's definitely the better solution for me than the republic, because I also need the military actions quite heavily, especially now that the strategy is taken away. So I will go for the constitutional monarchy. I also came to the conclusion that I really want to have the selective breeding, because when we take a look at the other civilizations, we can see that none of them actually have taken irrigation. There is the ocean liner service, so it's still possible that everyone gets a solution, but I think the selective breeding definitely is worth quite something. And then of course I really wanted to take this breakthrough here, as it is a very nice card to get for one civil action. But at the end I came to the conclusion that it is just safer to take the organized religion here. Maybe you could say I shouldn't play it safe, I got hit by some annoying stuff and maybe should now start taking some more risks. But I think that could definitely backfire quite quickly if I don't have the organized religion available, because it's actually already the second copy, there's only a copy of Team Sports left. Maybe if I don't take the organized religion, Swin will just take it, but if not, then he is right in front of me and he might also then still want to go for a happy face solution. So, and there would only be the Team Sports left, so that could be risky in that regard, but it could also be important to have a happy face solution already in hand now, instead of maybe getting the Team Sports at some point later on, because Swin just invested into the strategy to make sure that he is not the weakest. Maybe he would do it anyway, but he has the knowledge of Joan of Arc, there could potentially be a strength event on top. And there are some where it could really benefit me a lot to have a happy face solution. For example, if there is a Reign of Terror revealed, I lose a population and have immediately an uprising issue. If there are the Uncertain Borders, I would lose a yellow token in my bank and I have immediately an uprising issue. And I think for such situations it could just be very, very important to have the organized religion available. And I also came to the conclusion that the selective breeding is something that I really want to have. And so at the end, sadly, I made a decision to pass on the breakthrough here. There is another issue, and that is that I really can't do anything to make sure to defend against a potential aggression from Mata Pescheur. There's just nothing I can do. The only thing that I can do is to hope that I maybe draw a defense card, or that maybe Mata Pescheur doesn't go for an aggression, but he did quite some investments, so that is maybe not that likely. And I was very happy that I actually do draw a defense card, And yeah, and also the Conquistador's tactic could be quite interesting. So I was very relieved to see that. I had some H2 draws already before. It's now my 7th draw, so it's not that unlikely that I have an H2 defense card by now, but Himmata Beshir knows that I went into this draw without having any H2 card, so it's still also quite lucky that I get this card now. Himmelstosh Seeds, and as you can see, sadly, there is indeed a bad strength event on top, the Uncertain Borders, but now it can really pay off that I have taken the Organized Religion. Himmelstosh will then go for the Breakthrough, goes for the Patriotism, the Revolutionary Idea, so he just takes some cards and then develops the Bread and Circuses, which maybe could indicate it as a Dark Ages coming. I don't know if I had knowledge about this event or not, but he will develop it and then also goes for some more upgrades. It's now at 18 strength, so it's also looking quite a bit dangerous. And Mata Beshir will indeed try an aggression in H2 Blunder, and so that defense card draw could turn out to be very important. And I was really happy that I actually can defend against this aggression. I could have also considered, instead of using an H1 Colonization card, to discard those two H2 cards. But I think the Conquistador's tactic could actually be relatively useful soon, because the next turn, if I build an Organized Religion, I can then maybe also build another Knight, reveal the tactic, and that could improve my strength by quite a bit immediately, and could maybe help me to not get hit by even more aggressions. Mata Beshir then goes for the Organized Religion, plays an Urban Growth for that, takes the Architecture, takes the Scientific Method, and also takes the Efficient Upgrade. And sadly, there is another H2 aggression. The Spy is willing to sacrifice a warrior with that he knows exactly, or actually he doesn't know exactly, but he knows that if I have not another defense card available, then he is successful. I have two cards in hand, now he's at 15 strength, so I would need another H2 defense card, but sadly I didn't draw that many, and with that I sadly get hit by an aggression nonetheless. So having the defense card at the end sadly didn't save me from an aggression, and even without them I would have been safe from an aggression from Swin, and yeah, so sadly I lose 5 science to the Spy now. And those 5 science will also allow Swin to go for the Republic immediately. He's now at 9 civil actions, so that's definitely quite strong. Has also his second coal upgrade already going, plays the Patriotism, builds a warrior going up to 14 strength, and then he will just take the cannons and the opera. At least he takes only the cannons, making it that I maybe still have a shot to get the Rifleman for the Conquistadors, but for Swin I think it makes sense to only go for the cannons. Either he has already a nice tactic drawn, but if not, then there is the mobile artillery, which he may be at some point, maybe he can then transition into this tactic. At my turn, as you can see, I will go for Anthony Goudy. Barbarossa at the moment isn't really doing that much. I can't set up some food production this turn because I need to go for the Organized Religion in order to fix my uprising issue. So Barbarossa isn't really doing that much. Also, it's already relatively late in H2. And there could still be James Cook, but he's maybe not that interesting. Bach, maybe also not that interesting. Maybe he has, of course, some comeback potential if I somehow can set up some operas with him. Catherine could be fine, but I don't know when those leaders will be available, so I go for Anthony Goudy. Of course, there is also Maria, and she definitely also could be considered. I don't have any food production for now, but I want to maybe go for some riflemen soon, and then I could maybe get already 6 resources in 2 turns out of her, and at some point I will also be able to increase my population again. So if Maria also would have been in 1 civil action, I think I might have gone for her instead of Anthony Goudy, but her being once civil action more expensive just makes a big difference, as you can see at the end of this turn. So I at the end make the decision to go for Anthony Goudy. At least I can even save 1 science immediately when I now go for the Organized Religion, and I get a little bit of culture production going. So when we take a look, I'm still at 0 culture, and yeah, I definitely need to at least not fall even more behind. But now at this point I definitely was quite worried about my position after getting hit by the Spy. Swin is now already at 9 civil actions, has a strong economy going, and also the other opponents have some more culture. So I definitely was not too happy about my position. I thought I have the worst position here, but I just have to try to still set up for something nice, and at least I can maybe after going for this organized religion, can go for another knight, reveal the tactic, making it that at least I'm at 16 strength, withdrawing 2 more cards, I don't get hit by an aggression from Himmelstosh, I can defend, but if I don't draw a defense card, can't defend against a potential second aggression from Artapeshur, so I'm still living, I'm still in a dangerous position, but at least this tactic maybe makes me a bit safer and also makes it that I'm not the weakest any longer. And then I also definitely wanted to take the Ralphman here. With going for the Ralphman, maybe I can finally really stabilize myself. And then, as you can see, I have one civil action left, and with that, I want to take the wave. If I would have gone for Maria, I might have gotten some resource out of her, but I just would have missed out on the wave, and because of that, I think Anthony Gaudi is the better decision here. I draw 2 cards, this time no defense cards, so if Matabeshir goes for an aggression, I can't defend myself. Himmelstosh goes for Maria Theresa. She's definitely a nice leader for him, especially now that he will get some food production going. He has quite a nice yellow bank. Maybe there are still some colonies coming, and Maria Theresa has, of course, quite some potential. Matabeshir seats, and the knowledge of the ancients is revealed, so some additional signs for everyone. He will go for another cannon, upgrades his last mine, takes the urban growth, takes Catherine, he also needs a new leader. And with Catherine, he is threatening to maybe steal a yellow token immediately at the next turn, and also remains the strongest thanks to building this cannon. Interestingly, he then invests into the architecture, meaning that he can't go for the scientific method at the next turn, but maybe that he doesn't want to do this anyway, and one reason to develop that could definitely be that he still needs a food solution, and if the ocean liner service is available on the 2 civil action area or cheaper now thanks to the architecture, he can just take and finish it, so it could potentially make a difference to already have developed the architecture, and maybe that was one of the reasons why he already committed to it, instead of maybe leaving himself open to also be able to go for the scientific method at the next turn. Swin offers even the promise of military protection to Matabeshir, giving him even more strength. That definitely doesn't make the situation less dangerous, or I was definitely not too happy to see this. And Swin goes for the selective breeding, makes sure to get some food production going, takes the team spots. But I have taken the second copy of Organized Religion, he still needs a happy face illusion, and with getting the team spots, he at least can also go for Darwin. However, even though the age very likely will end before his next turn, he can't really elect Darwin, because then he would lose the happy face from the religion and would have some uprising issues, so he only takes Darwin in hand for now. Now it is my turn. I could potentially consider to start seeding now, because I am not the weakest, and the freedom of movement could at least be somewhat fine. On the other hand, at the moment, there's not really a very nice transitioning that I can do. I have my workers mostly there where I want them to have. The arms industry has some potential, but it also didn't feel too great, so at the end I still just skipped seeding and went for the Rifleman. I just need to get some more strength going so that I'm not that likely to get hit by an aggression. And I can play the Wave of Nationalism for 4 resources, go for 2 upgrades. And now, with being at 24 strength, I at least have somewhat stabilized myself in strength. But sadly, to the promise of Military Protection Pact, I'm still in danger of getting hit by Matabeshir and Catherine. So I'm potentially losing yellow token. As you can see, that could actually be quite bad for me, because I have the Apocritus tokens, but if Matabeshir uses Catherine's ability, then I have an uprising issue immediately the next turn. The question is, of course, what can I do about it? If I want to go for those Rifemen, then and the Wave of Nationalism, then I have only 4 civil actions left. One idea could have been to not use the wave and just take both copies of reserves, then I can play both of them for food and I don't have to delete anything. That would be nice in the sense that I don't have to delete anything, which is definitely annoying, but it would also be quite costly, would take a lot of civil actions, and at the end I didn't want to do dissolution. Instead I rather made sure to get some food production going and then took the frugality. That means that if Matabeshir uses Catherine's ability, I likely have to destroy something, it will very likely be this farm, and then I might be stuck on 2 food, so it's definitely also tricky. But maybe I can hope to get another copy of reserves, or maybe even one of those copies of reserves still at some point. And then being a 2 food now, maybe I can then again get another population out. But it's definitely annoying that Matabeshir can now still steal the yellow token thanks to the promise of Military Protection Pact, and it might cause some issues for me at the next turn. I draw two more cards, the Refugees and the Historic Territory. Himmelstosh then develops the Cavalryman, plays the Patriotism, also has three additional resources thanks to Maria available, and he also will go for the Suez Canal, and then builds two Cavalrymen, and reveals the classic army tactic and is now even at 30 strength. The next turn he can then finish the Suez Canal, and with already having two colonies, that will definitely be quite a strong wonder for him. And Marta Pescheur gets maybe quite a bit unfortunate here, because as you can see, there's one last card in the deck from H2, and it is the Oceanliner Service, a card that he's maybe hoping for, because he's the one that missed out on the Selective Breedings. I mean, with it staying on 3, he would not be able to take and finish it immediately, but it could maybe still be nice for him to take it at least, to make sure that he can get it, but now he doesn't have this option available. He goes for the cannons, making sure that he gets even stronger now at 34 strength, and then he takes both of those reserves, maybe can get a new population thanks to them, and is maybe hoping to get then the Oceanliner Service at the next turn. H3 starts. And at least there is now something nice happening. The International Trade Agreement is offered to me. Soon gets an additional resource production. I get an additional food production, which I very happily accepted, because first of all, the additional food means that even when I destroy this farm now, I still have at least +1 production. And also Marta Pescheur is now back to 30 strength, so he's a little bit less threatening for me. And both of those things were nice for me, and I was really happy that this pact was accepted, was offered to me. And we can also maybe take a quick look at the overview, and we can see that I'm still quite behind in culture, but at least with the Rome Road switching to culture production now, and with having Anthony Gaudi, I'm starting to maybe catch up a little tiny bit at this point, but I still have not the most civil and military actions. I will have to delete something at my next turn. Both of my opponents, both Himmelstosh and Marta Pescheur, are still stronger, and at this point I also still don't have another defense card in hand, so the situation is still very dangerous, and with having to destroy something, I definitely wasn't too happy about this, and Swin has still the 9 civil actions, but at least at the moment he is quite a bit behind in strength, which could potentially turn out to be an issue for him. He then goes for the team sports this turn, gets a little bit of additional strength from there, and then he also goes for one more coal upgrade, and then he will actually go for the Oceanliner Service. That could potentially be a denial, but on the other hand, he has the engineering genius in hand, so he maybe wants to have a wonder anyway, and even though he has some selective breedings, he's also relatively deep in his yellow bank, and I think the Oceanliner Service will also still be very useful for himself. So Marta Pescheur definitely was quite unfortunate that it was actually the last card in the deck, and he couldn't take it, and now Swin goes for it himself. At my turn, I considered if I maybe want to cede, and because I'm still not the weakest, but there could be some happy face related events. And what I also thought could potentially be in there, because one of those events at least was ceded by Swin, could potentially be an iconoclasm, because Swin didn't elect Darwin yet, which is definitely a little bit suspicious. On one hand, on the other hand, he had so far, in both cases, good reasons to not elect Darwin in the last turn in H2. He couldn't elect him because that would have caused uprising issues, and now in the last turn, every civil action that he did was quite important and couldn't have easily replaced by electing Darwin. It could still be a hint towards iconoclasm, but it's definitely not the only reason why Swin might have Darwin still in hand. But I thought that I don't want to lose Gaudi right now, because I will actually do some stuff with him this turn, and so at the end I made a decision to not cede again. Because I this turn, after destroying the farm, I will actually go for one opera. I have just enough resources to build one, just enough science thanks to Anthony Gaudi to develop it. That has definitely some upsides and some downsides to go for this opera. The good things are, of course, that I have no 9 culture production, and especially if there's no iconoclasm, I can maybe keep Gaudi for a little bit longer, then I maybe at least can catch up a little bit of culture in the next turns. And also there's Marlene Dietrich coming down the row, which could be a very nice leader to have when I have the Opera. At the moment none of the opponents have any theaters, Swin only has the Opera in hand, so I thought it's not unlikely at least that I might have access to Marlene Dietrich, and especially with Iconoclasm being potentially in there, I thought it could be quite important to be set up for Marlene Dietrich. Also, I thought I am still in a not that great of a position and I maybe have to take some risks, and I just thought maybe, even though, because the bad side things are, of course, I invest 8 resources into this Opera, and I could have maybe invested into some different stuff, maybe could have just taken the Patriotism, I definitely could have played a turn that is safer for myself, and it is quite a big investment, but I just thought I need to take some risks. I didn't really, and yeah, I just thought maybe just starting some culture reduction could be a way back into the game, because only drawing something with my economy for that my economy is just not strong enough, drawing something with the military for that my economy is also not strong enough, and the conquistador's tactic not strong enough. I mean, I can copy the classic army tactic at some point, but I just felt like maybe just trying it with culture reduction, hoping that I don't get punished for it, might be a way to get back into the game, and maybe also allows me to get Marlene at the next turn, in case there's an Iconoclasm. With the last two civil actions, I mainly considered two things. I can even go for this rich land. If I at some point get another population out, then that could make it quite a bit cheaper to rebuild a farm if I want to do this. But if I get a new population, maybe I also need to put it into the military. So I wasn't too certain if I will actually be able to use the rich land. And at the end, even though it was a close decision, because the alternatives maybe also not that great for me, I took the cannons and the cavalrymen. Like this, I have some technologies in hand, I'm better prepared for H3 tactics. But of course, I also have really not that much science available, so it's maybe also could even cause some hand space issues to have those in hand. Maybe the resource from the rich land at the end could be more important, but I also thought maybe it could be a little bit important to take the cannons as a denial, because Himmelstosh has drawn 3 additional H3 cards already, and if he takes the cannons and maybe gets some more draws, there is definitely the chance that he gets the modern army tactic, and if he has the cannons, he could just very easily set up a very big amount of strength. He can of course also stay with the classic army, but the modern army would have a lot of potential for him. Like this, I remove this option from him, at least for now, until he has a chance to get rockets, and who knows, maybe he somehow gets some revolutionary ideas, and then could maybe also hope to set up an H3 tactic at some point. But it also could definitely block my hand a little bit, and a rich land in case I want to rebuild my farm, which could potentially still be nice if I somehow find a chance to do it. Then the rich land, of course, could have been also quite interesting. So I wasn't really certain, and at the end went for taking cavalryman and cannon. I do draw some cards, and I actually do draw the modern army tactic, and that could be an interesting option. But again, I need quite a bit of science to invest. I can also copy the classic army tactic, so it has some potential, but and now it could potentially pay off to have taken those cards, but it's definitely not an easy transition for me. And then I also draw the Impact of Balance and the Impact of Colonies, but no defense card, meaning that at Himmelstosh's turn I can't defend, but I had some draws now in the last two turns and rounds, so I was hoping that Himmelstosh and Matabische hopefully won't draw an aggression against me. And at Himmelstosh's turn, there will be an aggression, but it is actually not against me. Instead against Swin, who has the Magic Castle, but who is also quite a bit behind in strength. So because of that, Himmelstosh makes the decision to go against Swin. I was very relieved, because I couldn't have defended, but Himmelstosh also gets rewarded, and because Swin also is, can't defend. Himmelstosh then finishes the Suez Canal, and will get the autonomous territory with it, takes additional food that allows him to increase his population immediately, and then he increases population again, and like this avoids an uprising issue, and I think that definitely improves his position now, being now at 8 resource production, being now at 6 instead of only at 5 civil actions, so I think the Suez Canal definitely gives his position quite an improvement now. And there's actually another aggression, and again against Swin. And it is actually defended, meaning that Swin already at Himmelstosh's turn had the option to defend himself, but that early in H3, maybe losing 7 culture is not that important, so he rather kept his defense cards, to maybe have the chance to defend against potential other aggressions, and now he can indeed defend against this aggression, but for Mordvishur it's of course annoying that this aggression doesn't get through after seeing that Himmelstosh maybe was successful with the aggression. He maybe was thinking that this aggression will be successful as well, but it actually gets defended, but Swin at least had to sacrifice a unit in order to be able to defend. And I was definitely quite relieved, because if Himmelstosh would have made a decision to go against me with this aggression, then I couldn't have defended, and then Mordvishur would have also gone against me with the aggression, so that was definitely, it was really nice that I dodged this bullet. But on the other hand, Swin was also quite low in strength, and with that it maybe was also reasonable from Himmelstosh to play the aggression against him. Mordvishur will play both of the reserves for food, will increase his population, builds another cannon, is now 33 strength, remains the strongest, takes the patriotism, and is definitely still looking quite a bit threatening. But he missed out on the ocean liner service and the selective breedings, meaning that he is at the moment stuck on his current amount of population. Swin this turn can finish the ocean liner service, but he is now in quite a bit of a dangerous position, because he had to sacrifice this warrior and he had to discard some defense cards, meaning that now he might even be more in danger of getting hit by potential more aggressions. And so he will rebuild this one warrior, will elect Darwin this turn, but only to replace him immediately with Bill Gates, which could again be a hint that an iconoclasm is coming, but maybe he also just wants to generally have Bill Gates and doesn't want to leave this option to his opponents maybe, and then he takes the rich land with the last civil action. I don't have an aggression available that I could potentially try against Swin, so I had to make a decision again, do I want to cede or do I not want to cede, and this turn I made a decision to cede. I was still a bit afraid that an iconoclasm might be in there, and it could be a bit annoying if it is revealed, because then I would lose my leader now instead of being able to keep Anthony Goldie a little bit longer, but on the other hand, I will go for Marlene Dietrich now. I have the Opera developed. I thought the freedom of movement has some potential to help me, either with putting another work onto the Opera to get more cultural production, or with putting another work onto the military in case there is the need to defend myself. So I wanted to push, and I was willing to take the risk that maybe an iconoclasm could be revealed, but I'm also not the weakest, so I was hoping for nothing too bad. Sadly, it's nothing great, the crime wave, but that's also not too bad, but also definitely not great. This turn I will take Marlene Dietrich. I have only one Opera at the moment, maybe Chaplin could even be interesting, but on the other hand, Marlene Dietrich also has the military potential, making it that maybe I can just build one more Rifleman and copy the classic army tactic, so I think overall, even with only having one Opera, she is the better solution here than Chaplin, and so I was willing to take her, especially with thinking that there might still be an iconoclasm coming, and then there's also the first copy of Air Force that I definitely want to grab. In two turns I have enough science to go for that. If I copy the classic army tactic, maybe with having air forces, that could already be enough to hopefully make sure that I can defend myself, at least for a while. And then with my last civil action, I definitely want to take this reserves, being able to flex just a flexible card, allowing me to invest my resources wherever I want to, and also I can play it for food, which could allow me to increase my population at the next turn. But the question is, do I want to elect Marlene Dietrich already this turn? If there's indeed an iconoclasm in there, then of course it would be better to elect her. But as said, while Swin had Darwin in hand for a while, and while this definitely makes it look like an iconoclasm could be in there, I thought that all of the turns from Swin would still make sense, even with no iconoclasm, and so I didn't want to miss out on a cultural reduction from Anthony Goldie and kept Marlene Dietrich only in hand for now, and then took the reserves. I keep one impact, a tactic, and two H2 cards, and I also draw some new interesting impacts, the impact of culture and the impact of strength. And I was relatively happy about this draw, because with me going for Marlene Dietrich, with me having set up this Opera, the impact of culture definitely has some potential for me, could turn out to be a nice impact, and also the impact of strength has also some potential, with me having air forces now, with maybe being able to copy the classic army tactic, the impact of strength is maybe quite a bit more uncertain, but especially the impact of culture has some potential, so I was happy to have this option available. But I also still didn't draw a defense card, but luckily, thanks to Swin having sent thanks to Swin having to send away quite a lot of defense cards when he defended against Mota Pescheur. He is still the target of Himmelstorch's aggression, which I again was very happy about, and another successful armed intervention for Himmelstorch. And then Himmelstorch will go for the engineering, will go for the pro sports, will go for the multimedia, goes for one more farm upgrade, and plays the revolutionary idea. And then there will even be another aggression against Swin, so Swin gets hit really hard now, and he gets hit by a very bad aggression for him. The infiltrate is growing 9 culture for Mota Pescheur, but it's probably worse for Swin than it is good for Mota Pescheur. He will lose Bill Gates and will now play the rest of H3 without a leader. I mean, for now Bill Gates maybe was not that big for him, but at some point he might have had a chance to get computers, and now Bill Gates is gone and he doesn't have the chance to get some very, very strong production then. I thought that those last developments over the first, maybe let's say last one or two rounds, definitely gave me some hope back, because Swin got hit by 4 aggressions. He could defend against one of those aggressions, but also needed to sacrifice cards and a warrior to defend. So he got hit quite heavily, and even though he had quite a strong position a while ago and still has a lot of things going for him, he will now play without a leader. He got hit by those armed interventions, is now behind in culture, at least after my next production. And So he definitely had quite some big setbacks, but he still denied the Oceanliner service from Mota Pescheur. He will go now get the mechanized agriculture, but I think for him it definitely would have been stronger to have the Oceanliner service available. So I thought that maybe those last developments could maybe give me some hope back to make a comeback in this game. And Mota Pescheur will go for the mechanized agriculture, goes for an upgrade, it gets him out of corruption, takes the reserves, and that's his turn. Interestingly, doesn't take the revolutionary idea, but of course the reserves is also quite useful for him. And then Swin seeds, no iconoclasm yet, instead of prosperity, giving me 4 additional food, which I was happy about, because that allows me to increase my population without having to play the reserves. Swin then goes for the cannons, will increase his population 2 times normally, 1 time with the Oceanliner service, and then he just starts building some cannons, also a knight, and he doesn't copy the mobile artillery tactic, he doesn't have enough military actions for that. Instead he will play an outdated Napoleonic army tactic, and now he has finally stabilized himself in strength. He's now at 27, and together with Dimitri Castle, he has now enough strength to threaten to defend against aggressions. He also gets the second copy of Air Forces, the revolutionary idea, the urban growth, and upgrades his second farm. Now it is my turn, and this turn I didn't really want to see it. First of all, I will switch to Marlene Dietrich this turn, and I still thought that there is a chance that an iconoclasm is coming, and also I'm the weakest, so there could also just be some strength events. I have at least knowledge about refugees, but I didn't really want to see it, and instead I thought that I maybe can offer the peace treaty here. But the question is which player might accept it. I thought that Himmelstorch is maybe the most unlikely to accept it, because he, with having a lot of population coming, with being able to go for pro sports, with having had some additional draws from the Colossus, he definitely has some strength potential, especially if he should still get the last copy of Air Force, or maybe has an H3 tactic and gets rockets or something at some point. He has quite some potential, and I think he wouldn't remove the option from himself to declare war against me. Mota Pescheur, I thought for him it's maybe more likely that he will accept, but on one hand he might also still have some hopes that he can maybe do a little bit with the military, especially if he gets Air Forces, so he might not accept it because of that. But if he should miss out on Air Forces, I also thought maybe it could even be bad for myself to have this peace treaty with him. Maybe he can defend himself anyway, but if I am able to go for 2 classic armies with Air Forces, and if I get a war, maybe it could be bad to remove him as an option, because I thought if he misses out on Air Forces, maybe he could end up being the most vulnerable. But he has also the potential to just build more mobile artilleries, so he probably will be difficult to go for a war, but But at the end I just thought maybe the most likely to accept this pact is Swin, and as he doesn't have the most military actions to go for an aggressive play at the moment, he doesn't know when he gets modern infantry to make it that his Napoleonic army is not outdated, and he's in first position, so he maybe doesn't have that many turns left to declare wars, and also I didn't really thought that I have a good chance to go for war against him, because he has Dimitri Castle, has Air Force already in hand, so I thought it's maybe best to offer it to him. I was only thinking that maybe he could potentially reject it, because I get one more production, but there are still some terms to come. And it's also nice, of course, for me that he doesn't get as much culture out of the pact as me. Of course, I only get one more, but still. And so at the end, I offered the peace treaty to him, and he also accepts it, which I was happy about. And in this turn, thanks to the prosperity, I can increase my population 2 times with the frugality. So the frugality does still come useful for me. And then I want to build an additional rifleman, I want to get stronger this turn, I will also want to build an additional farm. I think it is quite important to get some more population out, and with building that I will even be able to get an additional population out immediately. However, if I want to build this rifleman and the farm, I have an uprising, and for that I need to elect Marlene Dietrich now. And with her I can also copy the classic army tactic, making it that I'm even one of the 2 strongest now. And with my last 3 civil actions, I made the decision to just take even more reserves in hand, and with those I felt like my position is maybe not that bad at the moment, because I am still producing a bit of culture, catching up to my opponents, and I, with the air forces and at an extra level of enough science to develop those, I should be relatively safe for now, and I can maybe just build more operas. The Hollywood is coming down the row, which could potentially be an interesting wonder for me. So I thought I have some potential here, but my position has also still quite some weaknesses. There are still quite some impacts that I'm not that nicely prepared for. So I was not too certain if I have any good chances, but I definitely thought my position has improved over the last turns. This turn I will keep some impacts. As you can see, I even discarded the more modern army tactic, which could potentially be a mistake. Has at least still some potential, but I have 4 knights, I would need a lot of additional science. There's only one, or there's 2 revolutionary ideas left, but one of them I won't take, that will be taken away very likely, and so I just felt like it's not that likely that I can do something with the modern army tactic. But maybe I should have just kept it, but I wanted to keep those 3 impacts, and maybe also 1 more event that I can potentially seed the refugees. Who knows, with the Air Force maybe I can make sure to be one of the stronger players, and then the refugees could be a seedable event. Himmelstor seed, and there's no iconoclasm, so that one wasn't in there, but instead a Cold War, which I was very happy about. That was a very nice timing now for me, because now I just went stronger, and now I got even 6 additional science, and with those 6 additional science, who knows, maybe the modern army tactic would have been an option overall, but now I have discarded it already. Himmelstorch will go for the engineering, will also go for the multimedia. It's interesting. I think that indicates that maybe he doesn't have a war, or maybe just doesn't feel comfortable enough to go for some more military builder, because he could also have gone for bro sports, build more units, and like this he doesn't even use the resource of Maria this turn. So I thought maybe it could mean that he doesn't have a war yet, but he also doesn't have the air forces yet, so without them maybe he just didn't feel comfortable enough, and the multimedia is of course a nice thing to invest into. Matapecheur seats, and a border conflict is revealed, giving him 3 additional resources. Swin will have to lose something at his turn. And interestingly, Matapecheur will go for the oil this turn, goes for 2 upgrades, destroys a farm, goes for another knight, is now at 40 strength. So he still makes it that he is a bit threatening, especially for an aggression. I thought it's interesting that he goes for this oil, because he doesn't have a lot of science left, he will miss out on the revolutionary idea. So he might potentially could lack something to invest those resources into, and it's also not that early any longer. Maybe he has the impact of industry in hand, maybe there's an economic progress coming, so there could definitely still be some reasons, or maybe he just didn't find anything better for him to do at this turn. And so at the end he goes for the oil, but he will now be stuck on relatively low science for now. Spin seats. And a freedom of movement is revealed, that was seeded by me. Swin will use it to make a transition into the mobile artillery with putting a warrior into cannons. He will then go for computers, and now of course it must really hurt for him to not have Bill Gates any longer, but the computers might still be worth it to prepare for some impacts and build a very balanced civilization. He also builds a religion to get a bit more culture reduction going, and then takes the democracy. Now it is my turn. I see the impact of culture, which is not a complete, say, safe event. There might still be some time until it will be revealed, but I just felt like I have good chances. Himmelstosh could maybe go for Mandela, build more multimedias, but I will go for quite some operas this turn, and so I was hoping that the impact of culture will hopefully be won by me at the end. And I also wanted to start seeding this turn. The inhabited territory is revealed. As you can see, I bid 5. I didn't really want to bid 5, because that would mean paying 2 units, which I think would be too costly for me. I think I would have, maybe, I'm not even sure if I want to bid minute for Rifleman. But Himmelstosh has only H2 units, he has the colonization bonus, so it's just very, very certain that he will be bid at least 6. Because it's the inhabited territory that synergizes nicely with Maria, he will get 2 additional science and culture when he gets the additional population with the colony, and he has the Suez Canal. So I just didn't see a world where he doesn't want to bid for this colony, and then he will at least bid 6, and I was then willing to bid 5, because I will end my turn again without a defense card. Matapesher is at 14 strength, so I thought it could at least be nice to maybe make it look like I have still an H2 defense card in hand, that I maybe build bit a Rifleman and an H2 defense card, or a Knight and an H3 defense card, but it might also be that this bluff doesn't do anything, but I still was willing to do it. Then Himmelstosh wins this colony for just a Rifleman, and I will use the freedom of movement this turn to put a worker from organized religion to opera. I thought about some other stuff, but it just seemed the best, because thanks to Marlene, the operas will still give me some happy faces, and then it's just a very nice movement. I don't really need the organized religion, I will get 1 additional opera like this. I will play 1 reserves, I get an additional opera again, and now I'm at 15 culture production, which is definitely something, and which makes it that I could even take a culture lead over the next turns potentially. And now after I've built this opera, thanks to having those 2 reserves still in hand, I can still threaten to go for 2 air forces, which should be enough to defend myself. It could still be a bit risky to invest those resources, but with those reserves I think it should be fine. And I also still thought I need to take some risks, because I could definitely get punished by some impacts. Sweden has a lot of science production, Himmelstosh will have a lot of science production, and I at the moment have not developed any H3 technology for potential impact of technology, so I thought I have to get this culture production going, but I also was hoping that with the reserves I should be relatively safe, and then I took the Hollywood and the military theory. The Hollywood is just the best one, that gives me already 24 culture like this with having Marlene, and who knows, there could be at least a little bit of hope that I can make it even bigger. There's still some H3 government form left in the deck, then I could build a 4th opera, or maybe I can somehow build a multimedia, so there's the potential to make it even bigger, but even with it, without this right now, it is still quite a fine wonder, and the good thing is the other wonders left in the deck are maybe not that great for my opponents, so at the end, maybe I could even be the only player that gets a reasonably strong wonder out of in the last turn, so I thought that my position has now definitely some potential. And with my last civil action, I took the military theory, taking it away from Himmelstosh, because if he has a strong H3 tactic, and now he also will get air forces, if he gets the additional military action from the military theory, he definitely has quite some military potential if he has drawn a war by now, and so I wanted to remove this option from him, and without additional military actions, he can't that easily set up a lot of military and declare wars. Then I draw some cards, I do draw 1 war, also the impact of industry, so that was not the reason why Matapesher went for the oil mines. Himmelstosh will actually put, I think, a Rifleman into multimedia, builds a cavalryman, and that will mean that he will make a transition this turn, takes the air forces for 3, goes for bros balls, gets some additional strength from there, and then he reveals the shock groups tactic. And with having the shock groups tactic in the Air Force, he still has some potential, but there's also not that much time left to him to maybe set up for a big war. Matapesher seats, and the Independence Declaration is revealed now. Sweden is the weakest, but doesn't have any colonies. Matapesher will use the freedom of movement to put an iron into another farm. And after Himmelstosh didn't go for Mandela, I don't know if it even was possible after he won the colony, and he Now Matape Sher will go for Mandela, will build an additional religion, get some additional culture production going like this, and he has also enough civil actions left to take the United Nations, not an ideal wonder for him at the moment. At the moment it even would only give him 8 culture, but maybe he has an impact to evaluate, and also the alternatives that he could get from the wonders are not that great. Sweden accedes and the impact of wonders is revealed. And that is not a great impact for me, but it's the best for Swin, who gets plus 12. And at least I gain one more than Matape Sher. Swin will play the revolutionary idea, goes for the democracy, wants to get some culture production going, takes the Manhattan Project, myth that makes relatively safe, that he can defend himself, and he also builds one more team sports, increases population one time normally to get out of corruption. At my turn, I again didn't want to use my politics phase, because all of those impacts are still a bit tricky. Impact of strength is tricky. Impact of architecture is fine for now, but Swin and especially Himmelstosh might definitely improve this impact by quite a bit. Impact of industry is not that great. Impact of balance is not that great. Refugees are also dangerous potentially because I won't go for a lot strength this turn. Maybe I could potentially just see the refugees for 2 culture, but at the end I just skipped my politics phase because I will develop the military theory. I thought that there might be some impacts that could be improved just with developing that, like impact of technology, government, variety, progress, of course. So I just, at the end, wasn't willing to see it. This turn was a little bit tricky because there are 11 cards left and it is not certain if the age will end or not. So I have to prepare for 2 different scenarios, basically. And that is also a bit tricky because my first thing, first of all, I have to make space in my hand, and we can also discuss about some other options, but I at the end went for the military theory, and then I want to get the military build up because I think that will be an important card to make sure that I will be safe from any wars. And then I thought that maybe I can just build a step of the Hollywood, play a reserves, and build another step. That would mean that I get out of corruption with the military build up. I could still build 2 air forces, and that could maybe be fine. I would have no corruption. But I think I have to be quite careful here, and investing 11 resources into the Hollywood could be quite bad, because Himmelstosh has still some strength potential. The fundamentalism is coming down the row. If he gets that, and if he has a war in hand with the shock troops tactic, he definitely could start preparing for a big war. For example, he could just take the patriotism and the fundamentalism, and then he could just increase his population, maybe not develop the fundamentalism yet, because then he doesn't have enough science for air force and fundamentalism in 2 turns. When he develops it, so he needs to take it in hand only for now, but he could just increase his population, build 3 cavalrymen if he has a war already, then at a turn after that he could develop fundamentalism. Luckily, at least, even when he takes patriotism, and even if I get stronger now and he gets additional resources from Maria, he won't have enough resources to go for 2 armies with 2 air forces. But still also already going for only 1 air force, and then maybe being able to go for an additional bro sports, and maybe even an upgrade. I think that he would be able to do. I think he's just missing 1 resource if he goes for patriotism to go for 2 air forces, and then he has quite a lot of strength, and I actually think I have to be very careful. I could try to take some cards in order to make sure to anti-age, but it's not that easy for me, so that is quite a bit tricky, and I also don't know if Matape Sher wants to anti-age, which definitely could be, because he also could be in danger from that, and I was hoping that maybe if I prepare myself better for it than him, then if he can anti-age, maybe he will anti-age. If he can't anti-age, then maybe I can make myself look a little bit more threatening. Because I made it that in 2 turns I can go for 2 air forces and another tactic. And I can even go for the tactic with building more riflemen, and I think 3 riflemen and a knight. And then I would come quite close. It would likely still not be enough to actually beat Himmelstosh if he wants to set up like this. But I could threaten more strength than Matape Sher, but also not that much. Matape Sher can in the meantime go for 4 more armies, and thanks to his food production, it wouldn't even cost him he wouldn't even have to delete that much. Actually, he has to delete quite a bit. But every army is, at least for the resource belong, not that costly. So I think, if I remember it correctly, he has enough resources. He needs 32 to build those four armies, and in two turns, or after his next turn, then he should have enough, I think. If he doesn't have corruption, yeah, he should have enough. So he would be able to go for those armies. It would need 8 more units into the military. He gets some food, but he would still have to destroy quite a lot. I also would have to destroy quite a lot, so it would be close, I think, which player Himmelstosh would choose as the target from an aggression, from the war. But no, I sadly don't have a free hand space, otherwise I could have just taken the patriotism to make me even safer and to deny the patriotism from Himmelstosh. But at the end, I just played those two reserves and took the tanks. Like this, of course, I don't take another card from the row, making it maybe a bit more unlikely that the age will end, but I let the fundamentalism stay on three civil actions. Himmelstosh can still set himself up, but he will miss out on a leader then. And I was just hoping that with me being able to threaten quite a lot of strength, that he either won't go for it, and if he goes for it, that there's maybe at least some hope that he could also go against Martha Pecheur. But the situation is definitely a bit tricky. And I wasn't really certain about my solution at the end. I will have two corruption. There's not really any nice way to get out of corruption. And I also still have to consider that the age might actually, or that the game might actually already end at the next turn. So, for example, developing air forces and playing one of the reserves for food, increasing my population, and then maybe building one. I can't really do this because then I can't finish the Hollywood at the next turn. So it's a bit tricky. I thought that if the age doesn't end on the game, and there are two more turns than for me. Then, when I develop the military theory, sadly I don't have enough for an H3 government form at the next turn, but I also don't have enough resource to build another opera and finish the Hollywood anyway. But if the game is prolonged, then there's maybe a chance that I get one of those three copies of H3 government forms that are left in the game, and then in two turns I would have enough science to develop one of them, and I would have enough resources to build a fourth opera, so that could be something nice. And of course, I would have to just do my best that I don't get hit by a war. And yeah, so it's a tricky situation. And so I was very interested to see if Himmelstosh will be going for war, if he sees that maybe it is not the best thing for him to do, as it very likely won't be a big war, and as he maybe has to miss out on Einstein now, that he has to take the fundamentalism for three, and maybe also the patriotism if he wants to make the war really big. So yeah, definitely a tricky situation. Of course, if I take another card from here, then while Himmelstosh could then take fundamentalism, patriotism, and Einstein, then of course he also has to is at the risk that Martha Pecheur will end the age. I think then it should be possible for Martha Pecheur. So I'm not sure if it is that important to leave the patriotism on 3, but it could still make a difference. It was just a tricky situation, and I was very interested to see. Now, I also draw Impact of Government and Variety. Both are very... I probably don't want to see them, but the government could potentially have some potential if I need, for example, an impact against Martha Pecheur. So, let's see what Himmelstosh will do. First of all, he will see an impact. The impact revealed is the Impact of Happiness, which is relatively equal for all players. I and Martha Pecheur gain a little bit less out of it than the others. Himmelstosh will increase his population. He will go for Einstein, meaning that he won't go for patriotism and fundamentalism. He will go for the democracy instead, and with that, of course, it is certain now that he doesn't have any big wars or anything planned. Instead, he just makes sure to set himself up that he can maybe score some nice culture and also prepare himself for the impacts quite well. And then he gets out of corruption with building two more cavalrymen, also makes sure to be one of the two strongest. He has now taken some cards, so it might be possible for Martha Pecheur to end the game. And it might especially be possible if he makes the decision now to take the international agreement that he reveals, and he will indeed make use out of it, takes the revolutionary idea and the engineering genius. Thanks to having the revolutionary idea, he can now play the multimedia, build one, and then with having taken also one more card, the multimedia, he will now make sure that the game ends. And that means H4 starts already, Swin seats, and there's another strength event, the international negotiations, and Himmelstosh is the strongest. Swin can now decide what he wants to pay for him. He pays him food. That doesn't change anything for him, but it will actually mean that Himmelstosh has the option to get another population out. But Swin maybe didn't want to give him additional science, because that might mean that he gets an additional technology out and the resources he needs for himself, he will go for the military theory, maybe preparing for some impacts, and then is willing to pay 3 civil actions for the mechanized agriculture. Maybe it at the end just seemed like the most important denial for him. I don't really need anything. Himmelstosch could need something, and the mechanized agriculture is actually the last technology that he can develop together with the satellites, meaning that now he can for certain only go for the satellites and so only for one technology. So at the end, Swin goes for denying the mechanized agriculture. And now it is my turn, and the big question was, do I want to see the impact of strength or not? Because at my turn, I will finish the Hollywood, and then I can set myself up to get 1 Air Force, which would put me ahead of Swin, would put me at 52 strength. Or 51. No, 52, because I can also move a knight into the Rifleman. And and then of course I'm stronger than Swin, and at the moment also stronger than Himmelstosch and Marta Pescheur. So the question is, can those get stronger and will those get stronger? And for Himmelstosch, it sadly looks like he can very easily get stronger. He just needs to build another cavalryman, and then he already is stronger than me. He also can just upgrade arena to bro sports, and the bad thing is he has enough resource to build a multimedia while still having enough to build a cavalryman, so I thought it is actually quite likely that he will get stronger. For the Marta Pescheur, the situation looks a bit different. He could potentially finish the United Nations and build another army, but that would not be enough to get stronger, and also the good thing is I have knowledge about military alliance, so there are no surprises from there. He has enough resources to maybe go for tanks if those are still there, and Himmelstosch actually doesn't have tanks, so he could even deny those, but he could potentially go for tanks. He has enough resources to go for tanks and finish the United Nations, build an army with tanks, but he actually doesn't have enough civil actions to do this, because he needs to play both yellow cards, finish the wonder, get population, take and develop the tanks, and he just doesn't have enough for that, so I actually didn't see any way how he can get stronger, and also there should be a strong option for him available that is maybe too strong to do something with the strength, and that is going for one movie. He sadly has enough resource to go for a movie and finish the United Nations, and that not only gives him more culture reduction, but also means that he gets +4 from the United Nations, so I thought he will very likely go for that. So I expected that when I see the impact of strength, I will not be the strongest, but I might be the second strongest. And with that, I thought it should probably be best to see the impact of strength, because all of the other impacts are not really that great for me. There are some where maybe could get a little bit of points against one or two of the opponents, but none has as much potential as the impact of strength. But what I also needed to do is to maybe do a little bit of calculation, because if I came to the conclusion that maybe Himmelstosch is actually the player that where I have the best chances, or where it is the closest, and if I maybe came to the conclusion as Marta Pescheur, I don't have any big chance to catch up to him anyway, or maybe he won't catch up to me. If I think that maybe it will be closer with Himmelstosch, then of course I might consider not seeding Impact of Strength, and then maybe potentially even seeding Impact like Industry, which gives me a little bit of points against him. But after doing some calculations, and I have drawn quite a bunch of impacts, meaning that we can't see it here sadly, because there's only a limited amount shown, not those that I've drawn, but there are 5 impacts in the deck that weren't seeded by me, and there were only 7 impacts left that my opponents could potentially have seeded, so I could definitely do some calculations. I didn't do very precise calculations, but I could think a little bit about the impacts and how nicely those would be for me and for my opponents. And there are definitely some nice ones, like impact of for some of my opponents, especially Himmelstosch, impact of science, impact of technology, impact of progress. So I thought, well, Himmelstosch won't get a wonder, he will get the endowment, he will get 1 more technology with Einstein, and can build another multimedia, and has a lot of nice impacts. Marta Pescheur, on the other hand, will be able to go for movies, has more culture already saved up, will get the United Nations, and I just thought it could be close with both of them, but I thought I might at the end have better chance against Himmelstosch, because if he builds a multimedia and Marta Pescheur builds a movie, he will win the tiebreaker for the impact of culture, for example, and so it is uncertain. I might have chance against both of them, And with that, it should just be best to see the impact of strength. There is of course the chance that because of Himmelstosh winning it, that maybe those two culture, compared to not seeding at all, could make the difference between the position for me and Himmelstosh, but I think the chance is just a lot bigger than that it will make a difference between me and Swin, or me and Marta Becher. Marta Becher very likely will even lose plus 10 against me. And what we also shouldn't forget, while I thought it is very likely that Himmelstosh will get stronger than me, maybe he won't do it, and then the impact of strength has even more potential. So, long story short, I think going for the impact of strength should be the best option here. I was hoping that there is no impact revealed that I might improve during my turn. Sadly, there is one revealed impact of technology, which is also not an ideal impact for me, but at least Himmelstosh and Marta Becher will very likely also develop one technology during their turn, so at least it's not that bad, because both of them will also miss out on one tech. But it's definitely not a great impact to be in there. But as said, from the remaining ones, from the remaining seven, five are in there. Maybe they're even more seeded in, so I just had to expect that this will be coming. Then I will finish the Hollywood, I will increase my population, and I will go for an Air Force, and then switch this to Rifleman to make it that I am at 52 strength. I considered, as said, not to not seed, and then I could maybe build a religion for one more additional culture reduction. But they are one of the impacts that could be in there, and as said, there are not that many left that could be in there, so it's the ones that I don't have knowledge about are very likely to be in there, and one of them is the impact of competition. So even if I don't see the impact of strength, I think it's just best to build this Air Force. Could maybe go for tanks instead, but yeah, I think it should be best to prepare for impact of strength, and so that is my last turn. And then Himmelstosh will play the endowment for 6 culture. He had, after the impact of technology was revealed, just enough culture to still play it for 6. He had 105, so 1 less than Swin and 3 less than Marta Becher, but he can still play the endowment for 6. Goes for the satellites, builds the library, increases population, and then builds 1 cavalryman, increases population again, upgrades 1 arena, and then just takes some cards. I was kind of hoping that he will only take this copy of movie and not anything else, because I was really certain that Marta Becher will want to go for movies, and then he could have let a second copy of movies stay on 2 civil actions, but maybe he has seen some other potential plays for Marta Becher, maybe with going for tanks, and so he just takes those cards away. And Marta Becher now disbands the unit of knights. He could potentially increase his population. He, thanks to the movies being on 1 civil action, has enough civil actions to then still build a movie and finish the United Nations, but it would also mean that he misses out on 1 culture production from Mandela, and now he has also 1 civil action left that he can use. But first of all, we can see if he will evaluate something, but he won't do it. And now with the last civil action, he can play the patriotism, and he will use it to build another warrior, but I was happy to see it, because I know that the impact of variety isn't in there, while there could be the potentially an impact of competition in there. So I was happy to see that the last civil action was not used from my perspective in a way that will benefit Marta Becher in any way. And now we can take a look at the culture before the final impacts, and it is actually quite close, as we can see. Marta Becher at the moment is in the lead. I'm in the second position, Himmelstosh in the third position, Swin is quite a bit behind, but he has also some impacts that could potentially be strong for him, so he is also not out definitely, so it could be quite an exciting finish. I have some impacts in there that are nice for me, there are also some that could be quite bad for me, so let's see what the final impacts have to say. And the first one is the impact of harmony. That is a fine one for me. 16 for Marta Becher and 20 for all of the rest of us. The next one is the impact of agriculture. And that is plus 14 for Marta Becher and plus 10 for the rest of us. So after the first two impacts, basically nothing has changed. Because Marta Becher one time got 4 less and this time 4 more than all of the opponents. Then we have the impact of strength, which was seeded by me, and that definitely brings some changes. Himmelstosh is now in the first position, I'm in the second position, and Marta Becher is in the third position, but at the moment it's extremely close. Swin is still quite a bit behind, so he will need now some strong impacts to still make it back. There is the impact of science, that's definitely one that is quite bad for me. Gives plus 15 for Himmelstosh, who has now quite a lead, plus 5 for multiple share and plus 10 for Swin. So Swin is now only 18 culture behind. He is getting closer and I'm now 4 culture again behind multiple share. But there is the impact of culture, which I luckily have drawn. And that gives me plus 15, making it that I can overtake Matapeshoy again. I'm 12 culture behind Himmelstosh. Catching up to him should be very difficult. But now the big question will be, can I keep my lead before Matapeshoy with the last impact? It's an impact that I don't have knowledge about. Or will Matapeshoy be able to overtake me again? And the last impact is the impact of progress. A strong one for Himmelstosh, plus 20, plus 10 for me. And it's not that strong for Matapeshoy, plus 6 and plus 14 for Swin. And with that, at the end, Himmelstosh is able to win this game. I'm in the second position, Matapeshoy third, and Swin in the last position. And yeah, that was quite an exciting finish and quite an interesting game, because when we remember how the early game went, I thought that I was in quite a bad position. I got hit by this early H1 aggression, where I lost my lab, which was quite costly. And then there was the rebellion revealed, which was unfortunate because I had actually knowledge about it and it only got seeded into the deck because Swin had drawn it with the development of politics. I think if I didn't miss out on something, that was the way how it got into his hands. So that was then quite costly. I lost another 2 civil actions to the call to arms. So at this point, I really got hit by some stuff, also then by the double H2 aggression, which luckily at least one could defend, but I then got hit by the spy from Swin, and I was in quite a difficult situation. But then, so starting maybe from the middle of H2, or the end of H2, the things started to turn around, and I set up Anthony Gaudi. I built one opera, taking a little bit of risk with doing this investment, but I had to take some risks at this point. And then I think a key moment was when Himmelstosh made the decision to go for the aggression against Swin, which I think might have been the better decision for him, but I didn't do any calculations and did take a look at how many cards every player has drawn. But he made the decision to go against Swin. It was successful, and motivated with that, Matapeshoy also went against Swin. It wasn't successful, but he had to sacrifice a lot, and even though I was not able to defend myself in this situation, Swin got hit by 4 aggressions. Even though Swin had a very, very strong position at the end of H2, I think, getting hit by all of those aggressions, and especially the infiltrate at the end, that just cost him quite a lot, and out of the sudden made all of the things more balanced, because before that I couldn't really see how I could maybe finish before Swin, but after all of those aggressions, things definitely changed, and all of the players were a little bit more balanced. And then, I just tried to defend myself. I got the air forces, I managed to build some operas, I got the Hollywood, and then I also got lucky, and with the impact of strength and culture had some impacts that I could work towards, and at the end, that was enough to make a comeback in this game and to finish at the second position, which I definitely am very happy about, because when we take, when we remember how it was looking in H2, I certainly really didn't expect that I will be able to finish at the second place. I thought that maybe I can somehow try to not finish last, but I definitely was not convinced in any way by my position. With not getting hit by any more aggressions, with getting the air forces, being able to defend myself, and with being the only player who had a very nice way to maybe set up some nice culture production, and then also that's not just nicely with the Hollywood, I was able to score enough culture at the end. And maybe we can also take a quick look again at the middle of H2, because to just take a look again how the situation was. See if it can maybe load. Maybe that's a little bit too early, but here we can see I was at 0 culture, but I especially want to take a look at after getting hit by the spy, because at this point I just never could have imagined, there we are, the spy. Get hit by the spy, Swin goes for the Republic, goes for those upgrades, and then when we take a look, we can see I'm still at 0 culture, I have those issues, Swin has all of the stuff going. And at this point I never would have imagined that I can finish before Swin at the end of this game. But that's maybe an example of how things can still turn quite around, and those 4 aggressions just hit Swin quite a bit at the beginning of H3. Yeah, so of course I'm very happy that I finished at the second position. I think in the first half of the game there definitely happened some unlucky things for me, but then the second half of the game things then went quite nicely for me again, and allowed me to finish at the second position at the end. And now with this game finished, we can also take a look again at the standings. There has again been one game finished, another two-player game, where I wasn't involved. DJ Parson didn't make a video about this yet, I think, unless he maybe just... I think this video will maybe not be released immediately today. So maybe at the point when it will be released, there will already be a video. But if you didn't watch this video, I think it is a two-player game against Himmelstosh and Matapeshör that we will see in the standings in a minute. So if you didn't watch this video, or if you want to wait for maybe DJ Parson covering this game, then you should probably stop the video now to not get spoiled. And for those who maybe have watched this or maybe don't care about spoilers, those can stay. And we can take a look at the standings now. And in a game between Matapeshör and Himmelstosh, Himmelstosh was able to win. And the full standings are now like this. I'm still in the first position with 21 points. Himmelstosh has 6 games finished as well, is at 15 points. Matapeshör is at 15 points as well, but has already 8 games finished. Cengizsip is at 6 games finished and 14 points, only 1 point behind Himmelstosh, but both of them have a very similar position. And then Swin at the moment is only at 8 points, but has also the least games finished with only 5. So for him also still everything is possible. So I am still happy about my position. I have a 6 points lead before the second place. Matapeshör has already two more games finished. But there are still 8 games to come, so a lot can still happen. For Swin there are even 9 games still to come, so there can still happen a lot, and I still have to make sure to score even more points. Alright, then I hope it was an interesting game for you. I think quite a nice comeback, definitely also with some luck at the end. And Then thanks for watching, have a nice time, and see you in the next video.